This is 7 National News, and in our top story, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi and Deputy Supreme Commander of the UAE Armed Forces, welcomed Prince Charles to the UAE, who was in the country as a part of a regional tour. During the meeting, the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi highlighted the historic and solid ties between the UAE and the UK, which he said are based on foundations of mutual interest and common will. He also spoke of the strong friendship and relations shared between the two countries, which stem from their historic ties and strategic interests. Prince Charles began his visit to the Middle East last Saturday in Jordan, where he met with King Abdullah II and toured the Zaatari refugee camp, which houses 80,000 people displaced by the conflict over in Syria. The UAE Human Appeal International is continuing the distribution of winter humanitarian aid to poor families in the Palestinian territories affected by the recent snowstorm. The move is a part of the Tarahamu campaign launched by the UAE President, His Highness Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan, which is being followed up by the UAE Vice President, Prime Minister and ruler of Dubai, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum. It looks to assist refugees affected by the snowstorm which hit the Levant and Iraq. Ibrahim Rashid, the director of the HAI office in the West Bank, said that their teams had distributed winter aid to 673 Palestinian families in need over the last 2 days, adding that the mission is a part of the intensive relief program set by the HAI in line with the Tarahamu campaign that targets 15,000 Palestinian families at a cost of $1 million. 300 top scientists from 71 countries are to explore solutions for world hunger at the hosted Scientist Programme, which is set within the upcoming edition of the Global Forum for Innovations in Agriculture 2015. Organised under the patronage of His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan, the Deputy Prime Minister of the UAE, Minister of Presidential Affairs and Chairman of the Abu Dhabi Food Control Authority, the second edition is set to take place in Abu Dhabi from the 9th to the 11th of March in partnership with the ADFCA. Attendees will have the opportunity to interact with 6,000 sustainability experts pushing for change and looking for collaborations. Ahead of the event, Mohammed Jalal Al Raisi, the chairman of the GFIA organizing committee, stated that what's interesting is that we are really tapping into the entire field of climate-smart agriculture, and anyone undertaking groundbreaking research in this arena is welcome to attend. He added that close to 1 billion people go to bed hungry every night around the world. And an initiative such as this is a significant step towards making a difference and will accelerate the development of solutions. Award-winning scientists set to participate in the programme include Dr. Kathleen Merrigan, who is the Executive Director of Sustainability at the George Washington University, and who's also named among the 100 most influential people in the world by Time magazine, as well as Dr. Mushtaq Ahmed, an Associate Professor of the Sultan Qaboos University over in Oman, who has over 150 scientific papers to his name. The UAE Programme for Rain Enhancement Science is calling for submissions by March the 16th, where 5 winning proposals will share a $5 million grant. Following the official launch of the UAE Research Programme for Rain Enhancement Science, inaugurated by His Excellency Ahmed Juma Al Zabi, who is the Deputy Minister of Presidential Affairs of the UAE, applicants are being urged to submit their pre-proposals online before the closing date. Aligned with the UAE Innovation Strategy, the research programme aims to enhance water security through international cooperation in scientific research and development. The research areas look to include the fundamental understanding of rainfall enhancement, data modelling, analysis and evaluation, as well as experimental design, technologies and instrumentation. Once evaluated, the entries will be shortlisted to an invited group by May the 1st, with their full proposals due by midnight, August the 17th. The winners will then be announced on January 2016, with the project starting just 1 month later. The licensing agency of the Road and Transport Authority is set to roll out its 31st number plate online auction on February the 17th, which will run for 3 days. Around 300 four- and five-digit vehicle plates are up for grabs and will include I, J, KL, MNO and P codes. Registration for the auction will be available from February the 17th and up until the last day of the auction. Mohammed Abdul Karim Nimat, the Director of Vehicles Licensing at the RTA Licensing Agency, stated that potential bidders must open an account through the RTA's website or use the new link to obtain a new username and password. Participants should have a vehicle registered in Dubai or a driver's license issued from the Emirate. And a security deposit of 5,000 dirhams is also needed, which is refundable should no successful bid be made. This should be paid through one of the RTA's customer service centres in Dubai. He added that since its launch, online auctions have attracted a huge participation, offering high levels of transparency in a smooth, hassle-free and time-saving bidding process. Top seed Simona Halep could face a tough quarter-final challenge at the Dubai Duty Free Tennis Championships after the draw was made today. Top WTA players and senior tournament officials gathered at the official draw for the 2015 Dubai Duty Free Tennis Championships this afternoon, which is featuring 9 of the world's top 10 women. The world number 3 could meet Australian Open semi-finalist Ekaterina Makarova, or the newest member of the top 10, Andrea Petkovic, who are scheduled to clash in the third round. Another mouth-watering quarter-final battle between two former Dubai champions is on the cards if second seed Petra Kvitova and fifth seed Agnieszka Radwanska can come through their early challenges. The top 8 seeds receive a bye into the second round, when Halep will face former top 5 star Daniela Hantuchova or Mona Barthel. Kvitova opens against rising star Elena Svitolina or emerging American Coco Vandeweghe. Third-seeded Caroline Wozniacki will face a qualifier or former US Open champion Samantha Stosur, and fourth seed Anna Ivanovic takes on former Wimbledon finalist Sabine Lisicki or Monica Niculescu. Agnieszka Radwanska will play either a qualifier or Caroline Garcia in her opening match. And sixth-seeded Ekaterina Makarova also faces a qualifier or recent Hobart winner Heather Watson. The first match kicks off this Sunday at noon, finishing up on Saturday the 21st of February with the doubles and singles finals. The lineup comes as world number 1 Serena Williams has withdrawn from the tournament due to an illness, as well as Eugenie Bouchard, ranked number 10, due to an arm injury. Well, we caught up with the executive vice chairman of Dubai Duty Free at the event today, who told us what to expect for the WTA tournament this year.
This is 15 years for the WTA Ladies Tournament, and we have an entry that includes 17 of the top 20 players in the world. Wow. So I think it's going to be a fantastic event, and I think from Dubai point of view, it's going to be very prominent all around the world on TV and the media generally. Well, of course, many activities goes on. It's a gorgeous sight here, and various competitions and events and opportunities to win a motor car and to guess the number of balls in a car and win it, to participate in the Dubai Duty Free Finest Surprise Draw. And every day there will be balls hit into the audience, and whoever catches a ball is in for a big surprise because there are prizes available. And it's a very leisurely party kind of 2 weeks of tennis.
Thousands of food fans descended on the Dubai Food Carnival over the weekend as a world-class lineup of celebrity chefs, more than 40 restaurant stalls operated by the UAE's premium dining hotspots, and a series of food-themed competitions kept crowds hungry for more. presented by Etisalat at the Dubai International Marine Club, was transformed into a foodie heaven for the three-day carnival, which is a headline event for the second Dubai Food Festival. Huge crowds gathered on the first day to see over 14 celebrity and hospitality chefs pass on the tricks of the trade in two live cooking areas, the Chef's Dome and the Dubai Food Festival Academy. Meanwhile, the Great Yalla Barbecue, a mega grill-off concept, and the Soho Grill's Ribs and Bibs eating competition tested contestants' culinary prowess and stomachs.
It's the second year now of Food Carnival, and we've seen it grow. We've moved location to Dubai International Marina. We've got a lot more exhibitors. We've got Dubai Food Festival Academy this year, Chef's Dome, great celebrity chefs, Simon Rimmer, Sanjeev Kapoor, Savina Rowe, and along with all the top executive chefs from key hotels and the Jumeirah Group. Got great sponsors and a real mix of diverse family fun, from circus acts to bands to hip-hop dancers. So I think it's growing year on year, and I think it's a very exciting, and also we've got 3 days this year, so it'd be great to come on down.
And finally, looking at two other news now, it's been an exciting weekend for sports fans here in the UAE with the WWE live event in Abu Dhabi. And fans are also looking forward to much more sporting action with the ongoing Six Nations rugby and the 2015 ICC Cricket World Cup, which began today. Abu Dhabi once again played host to some of the well-known WWE wrestlers who took the main ring to enthrall their fans with some special and signature moves. The WWE event returned to the UAE for 3 days of wrestling action with a thrilling lineup, which consisted of the 15-time world champion John Kenna, who won all of his fights during the first 2 days, as well as Seth Rollins, Wade Barrett, Ryback and Luke Harper, to name just a few. Prior to the main event, Ryback and intercontinental champion Wade Barrett interacted with their fans at the ICC Academy and signed a few autographs. With the ICC Cricket World Cup starting today in Australia and New Zealand, where a total of 14 teams are competing for the trophy, both the wrestlers expressed their support for the UAE national team by signing on the world's largest cricket bat outside the academy and also tried their luck with some cricket skills. Originally from Liverpool, Bad News Barrett says that he is firmly behind England during the ongoing World Cup, whilst he took the opportunity to polish off his cricketing abilities. Originally from Las Vegas in the US, Ryback said that it was his first attempt at the sport, which reminded him of baseball, adding that he is supporting the UAE team for the ongoing Cricket World Cup.
This is my first time here, so I want to show the fans in this part of the world what Bad News Barrett is all about, and I'm all about the ball hammer and a win. Well, I'm a red-blooded Englishman, so 100% my support is fully behind the English team. What I've played too much in my life, I think you probably could see that from my cricket skills, but it was a lot of fun. I always like physical activity. It's great that this place is encouraging kids to get involved with sports, because WWE is all about healthy living and encouraging people to be active and live healthy lifestyles, so it's great that this place has that available for the kids in this area.
The good thing about this is we never really know what to expect, and we really don't know who our opponents are going to be for the most part. So I take it I'll probably be three different guys in three nights, and like I said, the result will be the same with a shell shock on each one of them. This is my third time out here with the WWE, and it's a tremendous honor to be able to come out here. It's very humbling. WWE is worldwide, and we are growing at an exponential rate, and I'm honored to be a part of it. UAE all the way from the big guy.